Okay, now that we've added XState, let's actually try and achieve a hello world in XState, and let's get something working. What we're going to do is we're going to add a machine into a machines directory that I've just created, and it's going to be myfirstmachine.ts. We're going to say const myMachine equals create machine, and that create machine we import from XState itself. We're going to add an initial state of, let's say, not hovered, and let's say states, we're going to have not hovered here and then hovered. Now, what we're going to do as well is when we kind of add this create machine stuff and start using XState, it's time to start using the VS Code extension, which I'm going to add from XState, and it should come up as XState VS Code. I've got it disabled at the moment, so let me just enable it. So here now you can see that there's Open Visual Editor and Open Inspector. Let's just try Open Inspector for now. And I'm just going to make my face a little bit smaller. And you should see that the machine that you create on the left-hand side gets visualized in the right-hand panel. Pretty cool. If we add a not hovered on hover target hovered here, you should see that now we can go from not hovered to hovered by sending the hover event. And if we add the other half on, let's say, mouse out, target not hovered, then, and let's call this mouse over, then we get this kind of pattern. And this is super cool. So let's just go over at a high level what's happening here. We start in the not hovered state. And a state is a kind of mode that your application can be in or that your process can be in. When the machine, which you can imagine is kind of like running out there somewhere, like it's a process that's happening in your app, when the machine receives the mouse over event, we've said, when you receive this, go to the hovered state. And then when you're in the hovered state and you receive the mouse out event, then go to not hovered there. And you can actually run this machine that we've got kind of simulating here in your application, which is pretty cool. And we're going to look at Open Visual Editor a little bit later. So I'm going to export that, and I'm going to go into my, let's say, the home page here that I've got this hello world in. And inside there, I'm going to go const empty array equals use machine, and I'm going to import my machine. And here we have state and send. And what use machine does is it kind of runs your machine. And here, what you should be able to notice is if I just inside there, I'm going to go json.stringify state.value. And state.value, what this state is here, is the current state of your machine that's kind of running in your app. So if we go here now, we should be able to see that it's not hovered, because that, if you remember, was the initial state that we had set up. And so if we add a button here, button, which is going to be hover, and on click, we're going to send a hover event. So this send function is a way that you send events to the machine, which should be familiar to you if you've used Redux before. So if we then hover, I think we might need to refresh the page. In fact, it wasn't hover, was it? It was mouse over. If I hover, then I go into the hovered state. If I send the hover event again, we've seen, if you remember from our machine, in my first machine, that's like mousing over again won't do anything. And this is a really core concept of state machines, that only the transitions that you label as possible are possible. And so we need to add another button that says mouse out on it. So let's add another button, and let's call this mouse over and mouse out. Mouse out. So we have mouse over and we're hovered, mouse out, we're not hovered, mouse over, mouse out. And that is a really simple getting started hello world of state machines.